nation's highest award, the Congressional Medal of Honor, is presented for conspicuous gallantry and extraordinary fortitude at risk of life above and beyond the call of duty. Overcoming inconceivable odds, outnumbered 20 to 1, and wounded numerous times, Mr. Lemon assisted in saving the lives of his team in Vietnam. He refused medical attention until his more seriously wounded comrades were evacuated to safety. For this remarkable act of valor, Mr. Lemon is one of the youngest surviving recipients of the Medal of Honor. Acclaimed author, Mr. Lemon donated his book, Beyond the Medal, to the 32,000 secondary schools in America and has been praised by Elizabeth Dole, Senator John McCain, President Ford, and Secretary of State Colin Powell. A successful insurance and construction entrepreneur for over 20 years, Mr. Lemon was named the Million Dollar Man by the Michigan State Senate for his riveting presentation and has appeared on numerous television programs. When he speaks about honor, patriotism, pride, selflessness, and success, he knows what he is talking about, the real life experiences. He will help us to answer our deepest and most intimate questions in regard to our own personal courage, determination, and perseverance. He will challenge and empower us to make a difference through his stories, intrigue, and humor.
Now, we got any small town folks? How small?
1,300.
1,300, that's pretty small.
Seven.
How many?
Seven.
Cut it out. We're talking about making the right choice a little bit later on. Are you telling the truth? Seven?
I don't think I've ever heard him speak without leaving the occasion with sort of a feeling of, thank God there are people like that in the world.
Well, that's a terrific question. And I don't have that answer, but I think I can supply it, because I think the youth of the United States wants to know.
At this year's convention, we were fortunate enough to get President Bush, who spoke on a Friday. The following morning, we had Mr. Lemon speak, which was a perfect follow-up to the president.
Maybe more importantly, we have 2.5 million men and women serving in our military in over 80 nations in this world. They're a long way away from us, and they protect every freedom that we have. And you got to applaud loud enough right now so they can hear you around the world.
Peter Lemon is brilliant. His powerful, inspirational message is the best ever given in the Florida League of Cities conference history.
Now, today I'm not going to be telling you about the 12 lessons or the 7 steps. I'm going to share with you a little bit about my life. Mm-hmm. And hopefully from that you'll find a message, and also that you and I are very much alike.
The first time I heard Peter Lemon speak to the Associated General Contractors of Oregon was one of the most moving moments of my life. I rushed right home, booked him for my own organization, and he had such an overwhelming response. We're having him back again this year.
And what do? They send over a second lieutenant to discuss this with me. Now, folks, those of you who have not been in the military, it goes second lieutenant, first lieutenant, captain, major, lieutenant, colonel, and then all the big guys, the generals, okay? So they sent over the second lieutenant. Now, I know that he's been to these voice schools, because they send these officers to the voice schools. I know it takes them at least 6 months to learn how to talk like this, okay? Because, see, officers, they don't learn very quickly. Well, he comes to me in this officer voice, and he says,
you need to get a haircut before you go before the President of the United States. And I said, sir, I said, sir, I said, no disrespect to your rank. Of course, I was lying. I said, I'm not about to get this haircut. I'm going to go before the President of the United States just like this. He leaves dejected, and I'm thinking, whew, I can handle these officers just fine. Well, it's about 2 hours later. Now, folks, this is a true story. My mom's 87. She's alive. She's up in Fort Collins. She'd be telling you the same story. She's told it over and over. Mine might be a little different than hers, but not much. All right? So 2 hours later, what do? They send over this major. Now, he's been to more of these voice schools, of course, because it takes him a while to learn this, doesn't it? So he gets in front of me and he says, you need to get a haircut before you go before the President of the United States, sir. I said, sir, listen, I'm a civilian now. I'm not in the military. I'm going before the President just like that. I'm proud of my military service. I'm proud of the people that I serve with. I'm proud of my military uniform. I said, but I'm not getting this haircut. I'm going before the President of the United States just like this. And he leaves. And I'm thinking, I can handle these officers just fine. 1 minute later, folks, here comes this one-star general around the corner, taller than me, bigger than me, looking mean and tough, comes walking right up to me, gets nose to nose right in front of my face, looking very mad, and he said, get a haircut. And I went, oh, yes, sir. But folks, take a clear, close look at me right now. Don't you think I should have held out just a little longer?
I'm really hard on speakers when I hire speakers. And I searched and searched for, because we have an inspirational breakfast every year. And we've had some very good speakers. And all the tapes that everybody sent me and everything, I just wasn't happy with. I remember getting a mailing. And I remember it from Peter because it was like red, white, and blue stripes and the flag and that kind of stuff. And I remember getting it. So I went back in the next morning, searched through my files, found it, called him. I had a video on him, so I looked at the video and called him. And just dealing with him in itself was just, he was just the nicest, easiest person to deal with. And it was a perfect fit.
So now I'm finding the guys in my unit, and I'm starting to feel much better. But here's this other thing over here. They're wanting me, as a Medal of Honor recipient, to speak to schools, to be in parades. And I thought, wait a minute, this is way, way, way too much responsibility for me. And I decided I was going to give this Medal of Honor back that I had in the shoebox. This was just a few years ago. I called up Kenny Valdejuli, since he lives in Washington, D.C., and I said, I want to give this award back. You see, folks, there's a secret.
He's a terrific guy with a terrific message, and I've never heard anybody better.
No one will ever take that from me. But with being an American, I have a sense of debt. It's a debt that can never, ever be repaid. It's larger than me. But I can work on the debt over my lifetime. And as that is to be the best possible American that I can be. You see, you want to be a hero? There is a hero in all of us. That's why we're alike.
Join the thousands who have been inspired and encouraged by his extraordinary messages. If you desire a national dignitary that will transform your next event into a celebration never to be forgotten, then Mr. Lemon is your choice.